much class. This is a free class that I am doing for everyone. And a special thanks to Venkatji for letting us know how important it is. Let me tell you a few things about me. Although I have no course for beginners, to be very honest with you, I generally have no course for beginners. I never taught it. But still, if you are my student, then whose responsibility it is to take care of you? Of course, at the end of the day, it is my responsibility to take care, right? So that is the case. If you are my student and if you are having any difficulty, so my all support is there. Every kind of support is there. You are having any problem, just tell me. I'm here. The time can be an issue. Time is generally a constraint with me, but you are my student, sir. Whom you will tell? If you are not able to understand something, if you don't know something, then whom you are supposed to tell? You are supposed to tell it to your teacher. You are supposed to tell it to me, right? So, Venkatji have came across a particular thing that basics is not well accustomed with. So now it is my prime responsibility to make him accustomed to the basics of this, right? Being a teacher. So yeah, this is something that I do when you are into my course. If you have any problem, any issue, anything, I am here. Direct contact, no brokers in between. And you directly talk to me, you directly tell me that this is a particular problem. And this is the class for Venkatji. Now, why you all are invited into it if it is a class for Venkatji? There's a reason. You see a pile of books behind me, right? And let me tell you, I may not have read all of them. Right? The knowledge came to me as a tradition. And to be very honest with you, I don't read the books much. They are for the reference purpose. To be very honest with you, the books are just for the reference purpose and for knowledge purpose. But you know, I have an advice for you people. I have this advice for myself, I have this advice for you, I have this advice for everyone. And the advice is to keep on visiting basics. You know, basics are very important. And no matter, like even after 11 years of practicing experience, I am of the opinion that I know nothing about basics. Every time basic will come as a new challenge, there will be something more in the basics that you will have to learn that you will not know. So it is my very strong advice that every 5 months, every 6 months in astrology, you should start reading basics again. You should keep on reading basics again. No matter if you read a classic or not, no matter if you read a technique or not, no matter if you do a research or not, doesn't matter at all. But basics, you should keep on visiting again and again, because basics are very important and very essential. Now, when you want to make a building, the roots are very essential, no? In Hindi, we say lengthy theek se dalna hota hai ghar ka. So that is the basic thing, right? Basic digging that you do before you make a building. That digging, that basic, that foundation should be very strong. So for this particular reason, you all are invited into it. And more often than not, we keep on doing class on basics, 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 because basics are important, very, very, very important. And the importance of basics cannot be overruled. Today's class, we will divide into two sections. We do both the sections today, but recording, there will be two particular recordings. In the first part, I will deal about basics of all the houses. What they signify, how you understand them. We have done this multiple times. We will do it one more time. Right? And after this, what I will do? After this, I will go to the second aspect of it, Bhavad Bhavan. And in the matter of Bhavad Bhavam, we go and we find some very hidden secrets. You know what Venkatji called me today? And we were discussing something. And Venkatji told me that, sir, if 9th house is father, then 3rd house from 9th house, 11th house should be the brother of father. For a second, I was like, yes, it is. But then I thought, how many of us take 11th house as the brothers of father? We don't take it. When it comes to predicting about the 11th house, we don't take it. Do we? No. And it just flashed in my mind that I have Jupiter in the 11th house and more than my father, the younger brother of my father, Chachaji, the brother of my father have helped me in astrology, more than my father himself. Because my father is more into palmistry, he is not more into astrology. Chachaji is more into astrology. And he helped me more as compared to the father. Because Jupiter is in the 11th house. Everything about Tantra that I know is all because of my Chachaji. This is not because of the father. Father rarely taught me anything about Tantra. He generally taught me, palmistry only and few things about astrology. The major chunk comes from Chachaji. So when he told that sir, third house from the 9th house is 11th house, 11th house should indicate the siblings of the father, I was like, yes. But when we make a prediction, when we do a reading, how many times do you remember that? Not very often. Not very often, right? That is the thing. Second part, what we do? Bhavat Bhavam. Okay. So first of all, I will talk about a very basic thing. This thing is very basic as I am like just telling you, but many people don't know. And it is very important to know it. Because if you don't know it, it will become problematic to you. And you know, this problem I have seen multiple times. And I have seen this problem and not only to learners and beginners, I have seen this problem with very advanced astrologers also. And this is such a big issue that it should be tackled. You know that there are primarily two types of charts, although there are three types of chart. North Indian, South Indian and East Indian, but generally we are confronted with North Indian and South Indian only. East Indian we generally are not confronted with. And to my utter surprise, I was talking to one group of astrologers who have been writing into a magazine, very prolific magazine. And surprisingly, what I came to know that 80% of the astrologers don't know how to convert North Indian chart to South Indian chart, South Indian chart to North Indian chart. Many people don't know. So that is a basic thing that I will start with. Now these are the two charts. The chart that you see on your, that the chart that is on my left, this one, is North Indian chart. The chart that you see here, it is South Indian. Okay. Another chart is North Indian. So there is difference between two. In the North Indian chart, houses are fixed. This is always the first house. This is always the second house. This is always the third house. This is always the fourth house. This is always the fifth house, sixth house, seventh house. 8th house, 9th house, 10th house, this is always the 11th house, and this is always the 12th house. So the houses are fixed. And the Rashi is mentioned. Suppose this is a Libra ascendant. So 7 will be written in the first house, 8 will be written in the second house, 9 will be written in the third house, and so on and so forth. This is how the North Indian chart works. There the houses are fixed and the Rashi number is written. If there is any planet in the Rashi, suppose Libra is having Ketu, the planet is also written. Understood? This is what happens in North Indian chart. In South Indian chart, this will always be the Aries, this will always be Taurus, this will always be Gemini, this will always be Cancer, this will always be Leo, this will always be Virgo, this will always be Libra. this will be Scorpio, Sagittarius, Capricorn, Aquarius, and this will always be Pisces. So whatever is the ascendant that is highlighted, suppose it is Libra ascendant, so this house will be highlighted like this, or there will be ASC written. And as there is Ketu in Libra, in here it will be Ketu will be written. So this is the difference between the South Indian chart and North Indian chart. North Indian chart, Raj, house fix. First house is always the first house. The number of the Rashi falling in that house is written. In the South Indian chart, Rashi is fixed, houses are moving. So the ascendant is marked that this is the ascendant and other houses you are supposed to calculate yourself. Okay. Then, now, what is to be understood from signs? Sorry, what is to be understood from houses? That is important. Me being a North Indian, I use North Indian chart more prominently. No matter you are a North Indian or South Indian, you can use any chart as per your understanding. But make sure that you know about the other chart also, because these two charts are very majorly used. Okay. What is the first house? Basic trait. First house is self. First house is self. Everything about you, self and personality, your name, first house. This is one of my major technique, that your name should have a connection with the ascendant, because name is your personality, right? How do I know that this is Venkatji? How do I know that this is Abhilasha? How do I know that this is Naveenji? From the name. If I have to refer to Venkatji, I cannot say that he is a person, he is having eyes, he is having eyebrow, he is having nose. I cannot say. I have to refer to Venkatji, Naveen, Abhilasha. I have to mention, right? So how do you get that mention? You get it from the ascendant, right? So this thing is very prominent. Your name is always connected to the ascendant, no matter what. So when you are in a confusion, what is the right ascendant? Name. Because that is related to your personality. So name comes in the first house. Your overall body comes in the first house. Overall, eyes come into the second house, hands come into the third house, that is okay. But overall body, overall appearance, the place you are born in, your name, your personality, your habits, your traits, all these things come into the first house. Along with this, name, fame, respect in the society, recognition in the society, how people perceive you, what people think of you, the dogmas related to you, everything comes into the first house. For an example, I have Saturn in the first house, people think that I am hardworking. Now, I am hardworking or not, that is a different scenario. I may not be hardworking, but people think that I am hardworking. Because I have Saturn in the ascendant, that is the perception, that is the personality, that is the thought. That is what is related to me. Getting my point? So it is the overall body, personality, lookout, and also the place you are born in. It's very important. You know what? Looking at it, these things will look very simple. But mind my words, my friend. When you will spend 11 years in astrology, na, will come to this particular conclusion that this is true. For an example, suppose I have to do a consultation. Suppose Libra ascendant, okay? Someone is having a Libra ascendant and this person is having a confusion, that's the am I a Libra ascendant or am I a Scorpio ascendant, right? There can be a confusion. So if someone is born in Libra, what you will say? Libra indicates marketplace. First house indicates birth. So if the person is born in the marketplace, this is Libra. But if the person is born near a water body, that is a Scorpio. If the person is born near a river, it is Virgo. Getting my point? So where the person is born, a city can have all the type of scenario. Getting my point? So that is what comes into the ascendant. In a nutshell, these things come into the ascendant. Okay? Come on, tell me what things come in the ascendant. When I am busy drinking tea, I do such things. Asking people. Everything related to personality, related to body, related to name, birthplace, appearance, hobbies, traits, etc. comes into the ascendant. Along with this, name frame comes into the ascendant, recognition, etc. comes into the ascendant. So whichever planet is in the ascendant, he will give the trait. The traits of that planet will be present in the personality. If no planet, check the Rashi. Getting my point? So Libra person will try to look at balance in life. Gemini person will also try to look at balance in life. Taurus person will be like, you know, he will want to sail through every difficulty in life. Getting my point? Scorpio person will be secretive. Aquarius person will also be secretive. In his pot, he will like to keep everything. Secret, secret. Getting my point? Ascendant is personality. Okay, clear about the ascendant. There are many other significations also I cannot recall. That is the particular reason I tend to read basics again and again, because there are n number of significations that you cannot recall at the particular moment. This generally happens. And you know, as a practicing astrologer, I always, you know, whenever I make a prediction, after that feedback will come. Whatever, you know, like anything, if something comes, no, sir, this happened. Whenever anyone tells me, I will always be like, why I was not able to tell that this will happen. And every time you will repent that, oh, this basic of this particular house I missed. It will always be this particular case. Getting my point? So suppose someone asks you, sir, my health is not good. You tell him you will come out of health. You will have good health from this time onwards. Now you see the planet in the ascendant. Ascendant indicates overall body. So somehow it indicates the well-being of body also. Now if there is a good planet in the ascendant, in the dasha antar dasha of that planet, good health will be there. Bad planet in the ascendant, in the dasha antar dasha of that planet, bad health will be there. Okay. So in a particular case, what happened? One of my client was telling me, he was having some problem. It's a long problem. So he was having some problem and he told me that, sir, how, when I will come out of this issue, right? That he was having boils and pimples all over the body and it was pain causing. So you check the benefic planet influencing the ascendant, you check the dasha antar dasha of that planet and you predict. So I say, okay, your lagna lord is Venus and that is exalted. So when the next dasha antar dasha of Venus will come, you will be fine. Getting my point? You tell this. And the person, like, you know, drops me a message to give me the feedback that, sir, yes, in the Venus Antar Dasha, in the Dasha of Saturn, I gained the particular benefit. I got freedom from the disease. Now, after 4 months from that, he says, sir, you know what? By the time I have got, freedom from the disease, from that time itself, I am becoming very famous. Getting what? People started recognizing me. Even one, someone from newspaper came to take my interview. They have also published my interview on their TV channel. Normal person, normal farmer. He's into organic farming, normal farmer. Getting my point? So that time I sit and I think that fame is also a signification of the lagna. Why I haven't told this particular thing to the person? There is a repent. There is a repent that goes to your heart. that, oh my God, I miss this particular thing. This is why basics are important. Then there is something or the other thing you will miss. That will stop you from becoming a good astrologer. So revise basics again and again. Accept and complete. Now we come to the second house. Second house indicates eyes. Second house indicates voice. Second house indicates faith. Second house indicates family. Second house indicates wealth. Second house will indicate saved money, saved income. Second house will indicate investment. Second house will indicate photography. Second house will indicate attitude, your perception to look at the world. Second house will indicate. Now, ascendant is how people look at you. Second house is how you look at people. Getting my point? These are the traits of the second house. Family, wealth, money, eyes, speech, voice, face. All these things come into the second house. Wealth also comes into the second house. Treasure comes in the second house. Gemstone is a signification of the second house. Hidden treasure is a signification of the second house. So whenever anyone asks you, sir, which is the house of inheritance, it is second house. Second house is the house of inheritance. It is not the eighth house. It is the second house, which is the house of inheritance, because second house indicates treasure. So inheritance is a kind of treasure that your parents have kept for you. Getting my point? These are the traits of the second house. And gemstones, as I told you. So if the second house is afflicted, I will also give you some, you know, some unconventional things that you don't generally take. If the second house is having a malefic planet, you should not wear gemstones. Getting my point? If the second house is having a malefic planet, don't recommend gemstones. People have stolen this technique of mine and have taught it in their webinars. Right? That if second house is having malefic, don't wear gemstones. But if the person have to wear some gemstones, there is a way out that I haven't taught you, brother. So what will you teach them? However, if second house is having malefics, you don't recommend the gemstone to the person. Also, second house indicates speech. Getting my point? Now, see, why basics are important, I will tell you. If the seventh house is good, but the second house is bad, the marital life will be troublesome. Ask me why. Because second house indicates voice, speech. So whatever he will say to his spouse, it will be misunderstood. Getting my point? He will say something in a positive sense, but the spouse will misunderstand it. Spouse can misunderstand it. Getting my point? This is also a trait of the second house. Do you get my point? This is also a trait of the second house. Misunderstanding. Even, you know, let me tell you something. This is something that we have recently found. Me and Abhilasha have recently found. And I am very afraid to say this particular thing. You know why? This particular lady made a video on how to time when you will get your next job. People have shamelessly copied it. And they haven't made a video on it. They started posting it in the community. Either do some hard work or don't fool people. This is a sure shot way to suffering in life. You know, we always ask why astrologers suffer in their life. This is the reason. When you shamelessly copy from people, you are supposed to suffer only. I can say that I have never copied anything from any person. And I can also say that I am not suffering in any area of my life. My friend, I am extremely happy. Because I don't copy, I don't cheat. Simple. Good karma, good result, bad karma. That results, you know, in life, right? Whatever. But, so, you know, this is the particular reason that stops you from sharing. And I will tell you one very important thing, you know. Second house is first house and second house, na, these two houses are very important. Let me tell you. You check the planet in the first house and second house, the planet connected to the first house and second house, the lord of the first house and second house, and the planet situated with the lord of the first house and second house. Any important event that happens in your life, these planets connected to the first house or second house or connected to the first lord of the second lord, these planets will play a role. No matter if the thing is connected to the second house or not, doesn't matter at all. But it will play a role. Specifically the ascendant. Ask me why. Because the result is coming to you. You are getting money, you are getting married, you are getting a child, you are getting a job, you are getting a disease, you are getting my point. Planets connected to the Lagna, planets connected to the Lagna Lord, planets aspecting the Lagna are very important and very crucial because you are getting the result. Getting my point? So first house and second house for this particular reason is very important. In the matter of marriage, in the matter of childbirth, in the matter of birth of sibling, in every case, you know, second house will be activated because there is an addition in family. If you get married to someone, that will become your family. If you get a child, your family will increase. If you get a sibling, your family will increase. If your sibling gets married, your family will increase. If your mother, father, anyone dies, your family will decrease. Getting my point? The second house and first house will have a role to play in every dasha and tarkasha. Until and unless there is a role of first house or second house or the planets connected to these houses, nothing important will happen. So this is the importance. Getting my point? Why I'm telling you that you understand it is an extensive base. Second house is family, and the word family have multiple implications. So you think over it. Getting my point? You have to think over it. Understood? Coming to the matters of the third house. Third house indicates enterprise, courage, will, desire, risk-taking ability, business, siblings, and you know, the preaching, giving speech, oratory, writing comes into the third house. Writing a letter, writing a book comes into the third house. Siblings come into the third house. Enterprise come into the third house. Courage comes into the third house. Daring comes into the third house. Risk-taking ability comes into the third house. Short travel, traveling from Mumbai to Pune, comes into the third house. Getting my point? These things come to the third house. Now, you ask me, sir, this is a very genuine question. And I am amazed why no one is asking it. That, sir, when you tell that third house is courage, how we are supposed to use it? How we are supposed to use it? Let me tell you. I have my third lord exalted. So when I came to, you know, I know a lot of techniques, a whole lot of techniques. Few of them are mine, few of them are of other astrologers also. But when you read people, you know people. But when I came to astrology, you know, I took a pledge that I will never teach a technique taught by anyone else. I take a pledge that I will never teach a technique that was taught by anyone else ever in the world. So if I come to know that this technique someone else have taught, I will not teach it. Until and unless the person has stolen the technique from me, in that case only I am the beneficiary. But still, right? So that is what? That is a powerful third house. Getting my point? That I have the courage to take this pledge, which normally thinking you will think is a suicidal approach, right? It is a very suicidal approach. What I can teach, what I cannot teach, the things are very limited. I have to do research before every course. I have to do homework before every class because I cannot teach what others have taught. So out of all these books that you see behind me, I don't use even a single word of any of these books. Getting my point? If I have to teach you how to find profession, I know 20 techniques, but none of those techniques I will teach you. I will research the 21st technique and he will teach you that 21st technique. I will not teach the 20 techniques that have been written in these books. Getting my point? So this is what courage is. So when you tell a person, you know, see, suppose someone, a person loved a lady. Simple, common life thing. A person loved a lady, and suppose both of them live in Mumbai. And the lady gets a transfer to Pune or gets a transfer to Nanded, Nagpur, anywhere in Maharashtra. In that scenario, there can be two cases. First of all, the person will break the relationship as the lady have gone away. It was just a relationship, no marriage, right? So the person will leave the relationship and person will go into a new relationship, right? Weak third house. He don't have the power to take risk. Strong third house, the person will be highly determined. The person will keep on traveling every Saturday, Sunday to meet the lady. No matter whatever it takes. It will keep it, keep doing it for 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, whatever long. He can keep it doing for a lifetime also. Getting my point? This is the courage. This is the risk-taking ability. For this particular reason, you know, it is told in BBHS that if the third lord is in the fourth house, or if the third lord is weak or afflicted, marriage will break. Why? Because when there will be problems in marital life, this person will not be able to take the risk. This person will not be able to be a man and face it. Getting my point? If your wife is, suppose your wife got diagnosed with cancer. Okay. Now you know that she cannot do work. You have to do it. There will be added responsibility. And what you are getting from your spouse, that thing will also be diminished. Now you cannot travel with your wife. Now you cannot go out very often. She cannot talk to you for long, etc. Right? If your wife becomes diseased. What will happen for normal people with a weak third house? What will happen? The marriage will break. The marriage will be in doldrums. It will be on the verge of separation. For people with strong third lord, they will take this challenge as a challenge. They will be determined to do it. They will be determined to make it work. That no matter whatever comes, I will do it. So that determination comes from the third house for this particular reason. You know, this is something that anybody asked that, sir, 10th house is also business. Third house is also business. So what is the difference between them? That is why it is important to understand. Third house indicates courage. 10th house doesn't indicate courage. That's why 10th house also indicates job. Any kind of employment, be it job or business, is indicated by the 10th house. Why job is indicated by the third house? In the case of job, you are given one duty. You don't have to take care of everything. Getting my point? There is some work that you have to do. You are not endowed with the responsibility to find the client. You are not endowed with the responsibility to find the business. Getting my point? Someone else is doing it. Some salesman is getting the business. You are doing it. Boss is managing it. Getting my point? In business, from finding the client to delivering the service to looking for the result, you are doing everything. That's why it comes into the third house. So when a person starts a business that have no connection with his family, in that scenario, that is the third house case. If my father had a shop and I start sitting on that shop, it is the family business, second house business. If my father was a teacher and I started a teaching institute where I use the contacts of my father to get the business, etc., that comes into the 10th house. Do you understand? When I start doing things all on myself, like in my family, no one does astrology. Everyone knows astrology, but they are in their respective jobs. Right? My chachaji have been a teacher. My nanaji have been a teacher. My naniji have been a teacher. My dadaji have been into politics. My father is a civil engineer. None of them is a professional astrologer. Only I. Even my mother is an engineer. No one is into astrology. I am the only one to go into this particular field. No support. Getting my point? No support. That is the third house case. Do you understand it? When the person takes everything on his own. That is the third house case. Understood about the third house? Yes. These house things I am taking, you know, a bit in depth. And after that, you know, just telling you five significations per house is can be done anytime. Coming to the fourth house. Fourth house indicates mother, homeland. So this is important. Fourth house indicates mother. Fourth house indicates homeland. Fourth house indicates the comforts of mind. Fourth house indicates the comforts of body. Fourth house indicates vehicle, conveniences, land, property, building, home. Fourth house also indicates cattle. Fourth house also indicates treasure. Along with the second house, fourth house also indicates treasure, cattle. You know, things hidden behind earth. The treasure that you find below earth, na, petroleum, etc. Or if you find that treasure in your backyard, that is indicated by the fourth house. Conveniences, comfort, mother, land, home, family, vehicle, ease of living, comfort, sleep, deep sleep, undisturbed sleep, all of these things come into the fourth house. Right? If you think that I have forgot anything about the fourth house, you can like just unmute your mic and drop me the mic. Also, friends come into the fourth house. Right? Very close friends, you know, those friends who visit your family, those friends who have a family relationship with your family, they come into the fourth house. Getting my point? These are the matters of the fourth house. Now, suppose someone asks you a question that, sir, I want to settle to Canada. And he is not Canada born, he is India born, okay? And someone asks a question, sir, I want to settle in Canada. Will I be able to do it? Now, third house will indicate travel. Seventh house will indicate travel. Ninth house will indicate travel. Eighth house will also indicate travel. Twelfth house will also indicate travel. Now, two cases. A person wants to settle in Canada. He gets himself settled in Canada. Case one. Second person wants to settle in Canada. He got a work visa for 3 years. After 3 years, he came back. Or he, you know, put all his money and everything and went to Canada, but lived here for 2 months and then came back. What is the difference between two people? You know that second house indicates family, fourth house indicates motherland. So when the second house and fourth house both are afflicted, the person can become a permanent resident of any other country. If the second house or fourth house is under good influence, then the result of the family and the result of the motherland is very strong. So this person will not be able to, if they happen, will not be able to get the green card of any other country. In this scenario also, if the fourth house is under bad influence, whereas the second house is under good influence, in that scenario, you will say that you can get a green card of Canada if you take your family with you. If you take your mother, brother, everything with you. In that case, the complete family will be in Canada. They can settle. Right, fourth house is having bad influence, so he is supposed to leave the motherland. But if fourth house is having the good influence and second house is not having, and second house is having bad influence, in that scenario, no matter if he takes his family or not, he will not be able to settle. Getting my point? So this is the small differences, and you have to keep it in mind, because you know, multiple things that happen in a human life, you will find no significations for them in astrology. Multiple things, you know, this PR, you know, settlement to a foreign country, green card into a foreign country. There is no house which indicates settlement in a foreign country, to be very honest with you. Like live in relationship. Which house indicates live in relationship? Fourth house. As I told you, fourth house is a very close friend. Fourth house also indicates mother, family, comfort. So what is a live-in relationship? Live-in relationship is you living with someone with whom you feel comfortable. That is not a marriage, right? Marriages can be without love. Live-in relationship is not without love, without comfort. Getting my point? So live in relationship also comes into the fourth house, because that indicates, as I told you, fourth house indicates comfort. So fourth house will also indicate depression, mental tension, mental fatigue, not being able to, you know, enjoy things, mental pressure, peer pressure, mental trauma, depression, hallucination. No, like watching ghosts, etc., coming across paranormal activities. Why? Because paranormal activities disturb your mental sleep, your sleep, disturbs your mind. Getting my point? In the case of woman, you know, the breast area is indicated by the fourth house. Breastfeeding is indicated by the fourth house. Getting my point? So that is indicated by the fourth house. So if fourth house is having a malefic influence, there are chances of breast cancer. If in a person's chart the fourth house is afflicted, the person will not get to drink the milk of his mother. In that scenario, what will happen? The person will be given to adoption. So fourth house also indicates being given to adoption, because he is not having happiness of mother, he is not having the happiness of motherland, he is not having the happiness of, you know, things belonging to his mother, mental peace, solace, etc. is not there. Getting my point? So once you start understanding the basic 3-4 significations of the house, you can really delve deeper, deeper and deeper into the significations of, more significations of the house. Getting my point? I am being clear. This video you will have to refer multiple times. I know. Make a note of everything. So this time you make note, whatever you do, then watch the video again, make more notes, watch the video third time, make more notes, whatever you want to do. Okay. Now, fifth house indicates progeny. Fifth house indicates talent, intelligence, mind, thinking, progeny, talents, skills, gain of power, gain of position, ministership, advising people, your students, your teaching ability, your skills, acquired skills, professional skills, behavioral skills, the learning that you get after bad experiences, stomach, intestine, digestion, the रोग प्रतिरोधक क्षमता को क्या कहते हैं इंग्लिश में?
सर इम्यूनिटी
इम्यूनिटी
इम्यूनिटी इज इंडिकेटेड बाय द फिफ्थ हाउस बिकॉज यू विल हैव टू बी इम्यून टू प्रोड्यूस अ चाइल्ड. अच्छा, वन मोर. सपोज समवन इज हैविंग अ वेरी गुड फिफ्थ हाउस बट ही इज नॉट हैविंग अ चाइल्ड. Why? I have only talked about from the first house to the fifth house. You know, if the second house or the first house is afflicted, then the person may not have a child, because second house indicates family afflicted. Now, you are not supposed to have a new member in the family. First house indicates vigor, vitality, self. It will be your child only. So if the first house is afflicted, your body don't have the capacity to produce a child. Many people are physically weak. In the case of female, the fourth house is also very important, because fourth house indicates mother. In the case of a lady, if the fourth house is afflicted, you are not fortunate enough to become a mother. You as a mother and your mother both comes into the fourth house. Getting my point? Males having good planets in the fourth house, you know, they're very much attached to their children. You will see, no, those men who are who carry their children on their shoulder 24/7, they become a mother like to their children despite being a male. That is the fourth house scenario. All these northeast men, you will see, no, they are highly attached to their children. You'll always see northeast men will have a basket on their chest and they'll put their child into it and they'll travel with it, right? The Northeast people are very good people. They have been very suppressed by Englishmen in previous times. More than us, more than the North Indians, Northeast Indians, right? They're still being suppressed by many people. However, these are the traits of the fifth house. Fifth house is your ability to produce things. So whether be it producing a research paper or producing a child, fifth house also indicates ideas, thoughts, thinking, intelligence, skills, etc. So if someone is good at singing by birth, that is fifth house. If someone is not good at singing, but he can play piano very well, that is a third house matter. Because third house is what? Courage based skill, right? So if someone is blessed with a good voice, fifth house, talented by birth, third house, you learn that particular talent. Getting my word? So the one who is very good in playing the guitar, he may not have a good voice. He's just skilled in playing the guitar. That skill comes from the third house. By birth, the skills come from the fifth house. Getting my point? This is the difference between them. Anything about fifth house that I forgot? And other things we will do in Bhavat Bhava section. Bhavat Bhava is once again more in depth. Anything if you forget, we do it next time. Okay. Sixth house indicates enemies, competition, loans, debt. Servant is indicated by the third house, sixth house, and tenth house, all the three houses. Sixth house indicates you as a servant. Third house indicates home help. Tenth house indicates the person who is completely doing your work. So tenth house, full-time servant. Third house, home help. Sixth house, you as a servant. You are also a servant, you are also serving someone else, everyone is a servant. So sixth house, disease, competition, boils, acne, pimple, health issues, wounds, getting hit by things. Disease, competition, suffering, being suppressed, loans, any kind of disease. All these things come into the sixth house. So if a dog bites you, this is a problem of the sixth house. Attack from animals is the case of the sixth house. Any type of wound is indicated by the sixth house. If the sixth lord is connected to the fourth house negatively, in that scenario, an animal may hit you, dog may bite you. Because fourth house indicates animal, I told you, na? Fourth house indicates animal, specifically pet animals. Cow, buffalo, these pet animals come into the fourth house. There is a difference between the animals of the fourth house and the sixth house. Both the animals of the fourth house and the animals of the eighth house, both are pet animals. Fourth house animals are those animals who give you something, like cow will give you milk, buffalo will give you milk, bull will plow your field. Those pet animals who give you something in return comes into the fourth house. Those pet animals who don't give you anything, like dog, cat, rat, they don't know. You don't drink the milk of the dog. Dog gives you nothing. That comes into the sixth house. If you have a mouse gives you nothing. That comes into the sixth house. If you have a cat gives you nothing. That comes into the sixth house. Getting my point? So there is a difference. And attacking animals, you know, wild animals, attacking animals. Wolf, lion comes into the eighth house because the eighth house will indicate death and fear. So animal whom you will see and you will get feared, na, snake, lion, tiger, hyena, that will come into the eighth house. The fear of death. Okay. So these are the things about the sixth house: loans, competition, litigation, enemies, wounds, attack, disease, separation also. You know, temporary separation, permanent separation also comes from the sixth house. Sixth house also indicates celibacy, brahmacharya. So that is the term from the seventh house. So celibacy is also indicated by the sixth house. So a lady, you know the combination for extramarital affair. Do you know the combination for no extramarital affair? Let me tell you. Good sixth house, a strong sixth house, sixth lord strong, etc. No, positive sixth house, positive sixth lord is a combination that this person will never be an extramarital affair. Because his celibacy and his sense of dedication will be very strong. So someone with a strong sixth house, no matter how sexual they are, if they are not into the relationship, they will never go here and there. Good sixth house. Getting my point? Dedication, devotion, no extra matter. You cannot categorize it. You cannot say that the one who is beautiful will have multiple boyfriends. Why? Why? And beautiful people who are devoted also, 6,000 makes the difference. Because 6,000 indicates Rikhu, enemies and weakness. Weakness is also indicated by the 6,000. Be it the weakness of the body or weakness of the mind, 6,000 indicates Rikhu, weakness. Shed Rikhu, there is Kama, Krodh, Lobh, Moh, Matsari, anger, lust, greed, etc. These weakness, these internal enemies comes to the 6,000. So if you want to find what is my mental weakness, you should see 6th from my moon. My moon is in the 6th house itself. 6th house from my moon is the 11th house. Paisa meri kamjori hai bhai. Getting what? 6th house from moon is your weakness. Jupiter is there, sun is there. So people more authoritative than me, people more knowledgeable than me are my weakness. If you are more knowledgeable than me, I will keep quiet. That you generally don't see me doing. But generally I am. Whenever I go across someone who is, you know, more, I think is more intelligent than me, you will see I will not speak for hours. Listening and like, okay. But this is something that Abhilasha ji have always telling me. She's like, hey, whenever you meet someone, I always want to see, you know, that fierce aspect. But you know, you tell, I'm like, you know, like in the class what I am. You tell anything, I will give you an answer. So she is always like, whenever you sit in front of anyone else, you don't speak. I'm like, let other person do. So I have a simple answer. Kitne ko bhai? Main bolne ka paisa leta. Brave nahi bolna. Simple. So whatever be the case. Getting my point? That is weakness. Sixth from moon is your mental weakness. Sixth from Venus is your sexual weakness. Getting my point? So this aspect is important. Because then you can take it to other planets. Sixth from Mars is the thing that will provoke your anger, that provokes your anger. Getting my one? This is the thing. Sixth house. Seventh house indicates the road, travel, voyage, wife, people of another gender. People whom you can copulate with is in the sixth house. So people of another gender, relationships, business, voyage, travel, leaving your home, going out of the home, being a rebel, sexuality, opposition, people against you, people not believing in you, foreign lands, foreign country, water body, the path, the road, the place where the four roads meet. All these things come into the 7th house. Specifically, 7th house is related to, although people take it for wife, but 7th house is not wife, 7th house indicates woman. And for ladies, it indicates men. 7th house. Along with this, it will indicate travel, road, seashore, beach, business partnership, people you want to, you know, have a relationship with, have a friendship with, desire. And desire and winning in a war, people who are against you, people who don't believe in you, people who oppose you, people who think they are superior than you, all this comes into the 7th house. So let's go further with the 8th house thing. So coming to the 8th house, first of all, 8th house indicates death. Death is like, you know, end of anything. So the death of marriage is 8th from the 7th house or 8th from the 7th lord. Both the things, 8 from the 7th house, that is 2nd house, 8 from the 7th lord, both indicates the death of marriage. So 8th house first indicates death, fear, hallucination, hereditary disease, attacking animals, those who can kill you, the conditions surrounding your death, the disease which causes you death, wounds, attack, phobia, unfortunate events, bad times, upheavals in life, fear, frightening, natural calamity, like, you know, this accident, etc., you know, the tornado, or, you know, you see, now the people die in a flood, all these things come into the eighth house. Okay, hereditary issues, the family of your spouse, the longevity of marriage. These are the sections of Bhava Bhava, but still adding it. These are the traits of the eighth house. Specifically, ninth house is the house of fortune, and eighth house is the house of bad fortune. Bad events, natural calamity, fear, death, the reason of death, the things surrounding death, the conditions of death, right? Hereditary disease, and mental trouble, phobia, issues, you know, encountering ghosts, black magic, etc., comes into the eighth house. Many people take researches, etc., into eighth house also, but that I take into the ninth house, right? Because ninth house is the fifth house from the fifth house, advanced intelligence, that comes into the ninth house. Okay. Going further. Coming to the matters of the ninth house, indicates guru, preacher, teacher, father, elders, scientific zeal, research, knowledge, intelligence, fortune, auspicious things in life, auspices, benefic things, things that you get as a gift, things that you are blessed by from birth, past life karma, both good karma and bad karma, past life things, things that you carry from your family, things that you carry in inheritance. Along with this, austerity, auspicious things, fortune, religion, temple, visiting to temples, visiting to gurus, faith, devotion to something, following the dharma, going through the socially accepted way, the society, the norms and the thinking of the culture, history, historic studies, understanding, implementation of knowledge, advanced learning, higher learning, you know, like college, PhD, etc. These things come into the ninth house. 10th house will indicate profession, karma, the family of the father and the family of the mother also, things that you inherit from your family, that will indicate fame, loans, your full-time servant, prestige, the ability to produce a child, and your focus in life, your goal in life, your desire to achieve something. Sky is indicated by the 10th house. Yes. So, you know, pilots flying in the sky, air hostesses, all this coming to the 10th house. Sky flying, looking upwards, you know, having a target, targeting at something. Your dreams. Gain of power, government, high position, authoritative position, the position to order people, people obeying you, followership also comes into the fifth house. Followership are the traits of the 10th house. Going further, gains, income, daily income, wishes and desires, fulfillment of wishes and desires, maya, illusion, sensory world, things that you like, multiplicity, elder brother also for some people. I take all type of brothers, all type of sibling from the third house only. Some people take elder sibling from the 11th house and younger sibling from the third house. Okay. Gains, fulfillment of desire, daily income, money that you have in your hand, your earning capacity, wishes and desires, fulfillment of wishes and desires. These things generally come into the 11th house. Okay. 12th house indicates expenditure, loss, execution, confrontation, jail, isolation, living alone, being outcast, not being supported by people, going to foreign lands, being outcasted from the society, being outcasted from the place where you are born, your ability to take your family out of troubles, your ability to take people, things and situations out of the troubled times, right? Jail, loss, expenses, losing something, even death, loss of something, sadism, all the negative commenters on YouTube have a afflicted 12th house. Sadism, a sadistic approach, feeling yourself superior, not being able to see the world in a balanced way. These things are indicated from the 12th house. When the 12th house, this is something important, when the 12th house is good, the person have the power to take the complete family out of the trouble. And when the 12th house is afflicted, the person have the skills to put complete family into the trouble. You know the family shame, that you do something that your complete family is in shame. That is indicated by the 12th house and 10th house both. 10th house when your karma does this, and 12th house and someone else. You know, suppose your child goes to a restaurant and breaks the table. So that creates shame for the whole family. That comes into the 12th house. And when you break the table, that comes into the 10th house. Right? So things which cause, you know, shame for the complete family, that comes into the 12th house. Specifically, you know, the being alone, aloof, lone wolf, these things come into the 12th house. These are the basic significations for all the 12 houses. I will advise you to go through this video again and again. Make notes, and very important, contemplate on the words. My friend, contemplation is very important. The most important part of learning is contemplation and thinking. Getting my point? And then one more thing. Chidranavesham. Looking at problem in others also comes into the 12th house. This thing is wrong, that thing is wrong. What you are doing to make it right? Nothing. Keep quiet. That is the 12th house scenario. So very important is to go through the video again and again. Make notes, and very important, think over it. For example, 2nd house is family, and 4th house is close friend. So what is the difference between family and close friend? What is the limit of family and close friend? Getting my point? Think over it. For an example, applied intelligence is indicated by the 9th house. What does applied intelligence mean? 3rd house indicated preaching, and 9th house indicates applied intelligence. What is the difference? In the case of 3rd house, you learn anything, you learn something new and you start talking about it. That is a 3rd house trait. 9th house is the 9th house is you learn something, you test it, experiment it, add your experience, then you talk about it. That is the difference between the two. So in the case of multiple houses, you will find common significations, and at multiple times you will see confusing significations. In that scenario, contemplate on the other significations of those houses and then decide what is right or not. Getting a model, for an example, 3rd house, 6th house, 10th house, all three of them indicate surrender. So if you have a driver because you don't know how to drive a car, that is the 3rd house. If you have a full-time helper, that is the 10th house. And when you yourself are serving someone, the 6th house indicates job also for this particular reason. Because in job, you are a servant for your boss. You are a servant for the company. So servant comes from three houses and all three houses have difference in it, right? And also think on questions such as, you know, as I told you, if someone wanted to go to a foreign land, if someone wants to get a green card of Australia, America or any country for that matter. So there is no house which indicates green card. So how you are supposed to interpret it? So seventh house, ascendant is the place you are born in, and seventh house indicates the place where you are not born. So generally people having seventh lord influencing Lagna and second house and fourth house under malefic influence, those people will get a green card of other countries, will be able to settle in other countries. Getting my point? In the same case, those people who suffer the sting of partition, whose family they have lost in partition, that is very malefic second house and fourth house, no? Very malefic fourth house. So they have lost their family and everything in partition. Getting my point? Someone born in Peshawar living in India, missing his family. Happens. It happened multiple times, you know. This is a case. I will
सर एक भाव कैसे खराब होता है कि बस एक मैलिफिक
अभी बताऊंगा भाई. टेक दिस ऑरोस्कोप फॉर एन एग्जांपल. यू सी फोर्थ हाउस इज हैविंग सैटर्न पॉइंट वन. दिस सैटर्न इज रेट्रोग्रेड. एडेड टू इट रेट्रोग्रेशन इज पावर. मैलिफिक प्लैनेट रेट्रोग्रेड पावरफुल मैलिफिक. Benefic planet retrograde, powerful benefic, depends on it. So Saturn is there in the fourth house, problematic. Because it is a malefic. The lord of the fourth house is Jupiter, that is in the ninth house. Okay, I will tell you the whole story. That is in the ninth house, but that ninth house is sixth house from the fourth house. And I have already talked about when a planet is placed good from the Lagna and bad from the house, what are the implications? Question answer session last. We talked about it. So first of all, the fourth house is having Saturn. Saturn itself is a malefic. Here it is also the sixth lord. It is also the dispositor of Rahu. It is also retrograde. In Navamsha, it is with Sun further afflicted. You know, Sun and Saturn don't have a good relationship. The lord of the sign Jupiter. Jupiter is into the ninth house, that is, you know, sixth house from the fourth house, that is bad. Jupiter is 25 degrees, Sun is 29 degrees, Jupiter is combust also. In the Navamsha, Jupiter is with Mars further afflicted. Getting my point or not? Getting my point? This Jupiter is afflicted, the fourth house is afflicted, the fourth lord is also afflicted. Do you get my point? Do you understand how much affliction is there? So this person is born in Chittagong, Bangladesh. And he is very much, you know, like disheartened from the partition. He's a Hindu living in Bangladesh. So, you know, he's not into his roots. Now because of that partition, he have went into a Muslim dominant country, but he loves his religion. He also visited India. He visited Jagannath Puri with me. He is a very staunch Vishnu devotee. He wanted to visit to Jagannath, have the darshan of Jagannath once in his life. When we went, me and the two other friends, this particular person, when we went to Jagannath Puri, he started crying in the temple. He was hugging all of us and he was crying that Shivam Bhai, it is only because of you I have been able to have the darshan of Jagannath once in my life. I never thought that I will ever be able to get him about. So that is a good house from the Lagna. So the result, you know, the wish and the desire got fulfilled once in life. Get my point? Where does this person suffers the thing? Being a staunch Hindu, being a staunch, you know, Shiva devotee, Vishnu devotee. He wanted to visit Navadvip Dham, Jagannath Puri, he wanted to visit all the Vishnu temples, he started crying. The pain of two countries being apart, you know, this person is suffering. Look at my point. other such person's horoscope I don't have. But still, getting it understood. Yeah. So people who have lost their family members, people who have lost their properties, etc., because of partition, there are many people. There are many people. Getting my point? This is how you see, the house and house lord both are afflicted. Understanding astrology in depth is what I do. And understanding is not always talking about techniques only. It is understanding. Bruce Lee once said something, that I am not afraid of the one who knows 100 techniques. I am afraid of the person who has practiced one technique 100 times. You know what is the crux behind it? When you practice one technique for 100 times, you know that hidden thing that only comes through experience. Learning techniques you can do from books also. The thing about experience, why books cannot make you an astrologer? Because experience. So that's why you have to go with the teacher, because the teacher gives you thinking. Let me tell you, my teacher never taught me any technique. I could teach you a few techniques, by the way. My teacher never taught me any technique. What he gave me was pure understanding. That is needed. Understanding. You should understand things. Remembering and techniques, how many techniques you can employ. There is a difference between understanding and techniques. Someone asks you that, sir, will I get divorced or not? When you know techniques, you can only answer the question that have been asked, the thing that I was talking in the starting. When you have the understanding, you can predict even more. Let me tell you for an example. Someone asks you, sir, will I get a job? If you know the technique, you can tell, yes, you will get a job. But you will not be able to predict that in your office, you will meet someone whom you will be in an affair with and you will get married to that lady. To predict this, you should have the understanding. You think what? Technique will only tell you if you will get a job or not. You can only answer the query of the person. You cannot become an astrologer. Answering the query of a person, can I get a job or not? Why you need to consult an astrologer? Consult a career consultant. He can better tell you. Consult an HR. He can better consult you. Astrology has the power. Astrology specifically is astrology because it has the power to see things that you even haven't ever imagined in life. You think about it. And that prediction, predicting what the person have asked is very simple. Predicting those things that he haven't asked but is about to come on his way is something that is very important. Getting my point? So this is what you should learn. To predict the things that the person haven't ever imagined. Getting my point? A lady suffering through mental life issue, she takes a consultation and I tell her that 8 months from now, your question will go. 15 months from that consultation today, the lady is bugging me every week, sir, my business is going very good. Now tell me, how should I expand it? Which people should I employ? How to see from the horoscope if the charts matches for an employee? Because when she took a consultation, I was like, today this lady is crying for a divorce. 8 months from now, she will be such a good business lady. Getting my word? At that point of time, when she did the consultation, the business was even not into her mind at all. There was only one thing into her mind, that I want to get out of this marriage. She got out of that marriage. That was a very painful experience. But now, she is full business. She don't talk about marriage anymore. She only talks about business. Getting my point? So that is the power of astrology. You see that thing that the person is not able to. Getting my point? Otherwise, if you want to know the marriage will stay or not, better than astrology, your father can tell you. That tera nahi chalega re. You cannot. getting my point, so what is the power of astrology to see the things that you cannot imagine that it will ever happen? Getting my point? When I was into the fifth, when I was into seventh standard, I wanted to do MBA. And that time my father used to laugh at me. He was like, okay, okay, you do MBA. Because he knew that day, but you will not do MBA. Getting upon, so to see the unforeseen event is why you need understanding. Now, techniques, there are many. Right? Thank you. Sorry, I'm come again.
I am telling, whenever I am viewing your videos, I am thinking that everything you are telling for free only.
That is.
We have attended some of the classes. After paying fees, they are telling we are not giving, going to give this technique or this thing, that thing. And whenever I am viewing your video, 2 hours video, everything you are filling free of cost.
And
even, thank you very much. God bless you, sir.
Even in that particular scenario, you people know what I teach in technique and what I teach free is entirely different.
Yes, sir. Come on. God bless you, sir.
Who will take money from you and will upload the whole class live just to boost their YouTube views. What do you know about me? I'm pretty clear. What I'm teaching in blank chart prediction course is completely different. What I am teaching you today is completely different. The rules don't intermix, right? The separate technique for those people, even you know those who are commenting, that in the one hour session you are teaching this thing, you are wasting 40 minutes. My friend, because I have wasted 40 minutes, only for this reason, this video is available for free. If I was teaching end to end, my friend, why you should get the video for free then? Those are not who are paying money for it, right? So only those classes are given free when understanding is there. Otherwise, you have seen the course videos, you know. I am like quite against wasting time. Thank you for the feedback. The feedback will boost. See, there are many people to talk back. And as a human, it disheartens us. When you give a good feedback, it keeps us running. Yes, there are people. If they give good feedback, we enjoy it. Otherwise, see, it is very easy to see a bad comment, get disheartened. You're like, why should I do every video? Getting my point. See, all of my best and fine students I have with me. And you know, I know one thing for sure. People who have learned from different institutions, I don't want to take names, they call me. Sir, we have taken 2 courses, we have not been able to learn anything. We want to join you. Then they joined me, they never went anywhere else. So I know my work.
Sure, sir.
You people, just hard work.
God bless you. God bless you.
Thank you. Right, you go through the hard work. Any issue, any problem, Venkatji calls me. Like, drop me a message, drop me a mail, call me up, tell me the issue that you are facing, basics you don't know, tell me. Things you are not getting, tell me. You think any issue, any problem, I am 24/7 here. Drop me a message and I will do whatever best can be done. Okay? Let's meet in the next class. Thank you for joining.
Thank you, sir. Good night.